Introducing Covert Scouting Cameras by DLC.
Camp. Hurrying up before dark. See if we can find anything.
We only got about an hour, hour and a half.
Opening day tomorrow, so going to run up the hill.
These guys have been down here looking, though.
Yeah, they've seen some pretty good ones. So.
How many years did it take you to draw this tag?
14.
So
14 years.
Been waiting a long time.
Yep. This moment right now. So we're going to run up, see what we can do.
Some pretty country.
Holy smoke, those tines.
I don't think he'll fit in your office. I'm pretty sure you shouldn't shoot him. Yeah, I'm about 99% sure that Nicole ain't letting it go in the house either.
Yeah. Oh, that's going in the house.
What was that?
Oh, that's going in the house.
Yeah. You forget I'm recording.
All right. Wow, look at that. Is that before he busted?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Watch it, see what I got tonight.
That's better when we put it on.
It's my best hairdo right here.
Better than some of them I've seen you with.
You got one in your trailer?
Got the
you got zoomed in on this
all
at all
here watching the footage of the bull we're going after in the morning. We think he breaks 200, and Cory is pumped. He did say 200 or bust.
That's just because I knew that would be bigger than anything Clifford's ever killed.
I'm ready.
Opening morning, 5 o'clock.
Should a big one.
You excited?
Yeah.
I bet you Cory didn't even sleep.
After a long hike up the hill, our hunters found themselves on the backside of the ridge from where they had seen the big bull the night before. The nice thing about hunting elk in the rut is that usually, at first light, these elk are very vocal, and if you listen and there's a big bull in the area, there's a good chance you'll know he's there. As they came around the ridge, it didn't take them long to find the herd. Now all they had to do is make sure this is the bull they wanted and wait for him to step into an opening so that Cory could get a clear shot.
Right at his back line.
Right at his back line.
You hit him.
Another one.
Another one in him. You hit him again. He's hurting. He's going to go down.
Wait.
He's going to go down. Don't shoot again.
Sure? Yeah, he'll go down. He's sicker than a dog. For sure. Take another one then.
Hit him again. That's only a 5-point bull.
No.
Are you kidding?
What's he doing? He just went down.
You sure?
Yeah, I can see him.
I wasn't worried about your screen. I was worried about my screen. That's for Cody.
I couldn't see anything Core. Broken. So hopefully it wasn't anything more broken than he had.
Dude, you just killed a smoker. What do you think?
Oh crap, I've never been so excited in my life.
Hey, it couldn't work out any better.
Listening to him bugle, isn't that amazing?
Well, here we are, opening morning, 2009 limited entry elk hunt in Utah. It took 14 years to draw this tag, and it was all over first thing this morning, and couldn't be happier. We spotted this bull last night on the same hillside and came in this morning, and it's really thick. It's a lot thicker than it looks. And luckily, we came out in an opening where we could get a shot on him. So, couldn't be happier with him. We got my twin brother, Kelly, here with me, and my dad and my father-in-law were on another hillside watching. Cousin Cliff's on the camera, and his son TJ's here, and then Dave and Ransom have been watching this bull and a bunch of bulls for several weeks, and just very happy that I was able to get hooked up with them and they could guide us in on this nice bull.
So what is he score, are we guessing? We don't know until Dave gets here, but
yeah. We're thinking right around, he's a little shorter on the top than we thought, but he's got great front end on him. I think we're going to be about 370. Just
turn him a couple times and look.
Getting a little stiff.
Yes, a little bit of rigor mortis.